Oke, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Everybody, good. Can you hear me?
Yes, Pak.
Is it clear for you? Clear, ya? Presentation will be presented by Nafisha, ya. Nafisha, Arya Nuar, Prafajar, Suksesano. Is there? All presenters have been present, have been here, so we can start our session for now. Let's start the presentation. From the first presenter, Nafisha, the paper, which is ya, pokoknya. Halo. Aku enggak masuk. Testing satu
tiga. Ya, ini saya udah masuk. Ya.
Saya nggak ikut ya, nggak masuk. Ya.
Saya bapak belum. Ini bapak coba bapak ngomong.
Nah itu.
Telat ada tapi telat.
Telat ya, harus pakai ini kali ya. Suaranya enggak ini ya. Can you hear my voice? Hello?
Yes, I can hear your voice, yeah.
Okay, okay. So, okay. I just want to inform you that the duration for each presenter will be 10 minutes maximum, okay? And okay. I will remind you if the time is up, so 2 minutes before. So, you will have time for presenting. Have 3 minutes for question and answer, probably. Okay. So let's move on to the first presenter by Nafisha. For Nafisha, you can present now.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Nafisha Hermahanifa. Today, I will present you about my paper, the title "Site Selection of New Facility Using Gravity Model and Mixed Integer Linear Programming in the Free and Logistic Company." Next slide, please. So there is an outline of my presentation today. First is introduction that includes background, objective, and related model. Second is methodology that includes research methodology. Third is data collection that include. Fourth is result and discussion that include calculation, result analysis, and fifth is conclusion that include conclusion of the research. Next slide, please. So, start with the background. One of the type of business that is commonly found nowadays is the delivery logistics service company. In Indonesia, there are a lot of companies that provide delivery and logistics service. The object of my research is one of that kind of companies that located in Bandung. The table and the graphic on the screen depicts the delivery centers in that company. It includes in Bandung City, Bandung Regency, West Bandung Regency, and Cimahi City. The table shows the unfulfilled demand and the lost cost of each delivery center, and the graphic presents the cost of each delivery centers. Next. So the objective to reduce the unfulfilled demand, but the company requests to build not in the center of the Bandung City because okay, this is the table before, but these five delivery centers is the problematic area. But two of them, which is Asia Afrika and Situ Sahar, is located in the center of. Because of Asia Afrika and the Situ Sahar is included in Bandung City, excluded from the problematic area. So the rest of problematic area is only Ujung Berung, Soreang, and Dayakolot. Next. So this is the related model. The first model is the for the next is mixed interlinear programming to calculate the least cost of the facilities that chosen. Next.
Tinggal di rumah
kita masing-masing.
Tadi lama.
Okay, can you see the slides now, Marisha? If you can.
Methodology starts with observation and then problem identification and objective, and then data collection that include demand, location of existing facilities, customer distribution, and then data processing, which are selecting the problematic area, determining candidate facility location using gravity model, and choosing new facility location using mixed integer linear programming, and then analysis, conclusion, and finish. Next. Next, please. So this is the customer notes of quite far, but the farthest one is the diacolos one. Next. This is the village coordinate of Dayakolot. There are, if I'm not mistaken, 52 village of customer in Dayakolot. Next. This is the customer village of Soreang. Next. There are 44 village that include in customer village Ujung Berung. Next. This is the village demand of Dayakolot. So each village have a variety number of demands, start from 200 something to more than 1,000. Next. This is the village demand of Soreang. It also have a right number of demand for each customer village, started from 300 something to more than 2,000. Next. And the last one is a village demand of Ujung Berung. It also have a variety number of the demand for each village, but it have start with 400 to more than 2,000. Next. So result and discussion, next. This is the graffiti model of Dayakolot. It's a manual way. So first, calculate the volume times cost times x coordinate, and also volume times cost times y coordinate, and we can find the x and y coordinate, and then we can calculate the d, or distance between new facility and the village. And next is the total cost of the result of iteration zero is is 107 point something.
by the way. So let's read it for you. Is there any question or comment from the participant?
Yes. Delivery cost. This is inflation, not just like a value one vehicle or not?
It's only for. Per item.
Okay. Is that answering your question, Haikal?
Yeah, Pak.
Okay. Okay, I think we are running out the time actually because due to the connection. Sorry for that. So let's close this session and give applause for Nafisha virtually. Thank you very much for your presentation. So we'll move on to the second presenter. It will be Haikal Shauki. We were preparing the slides, just a minute. By the way, after the end of the session, let's have a video capturing together, right? Like a photo session, but in Zoom environment. In the end of the session. Are you ready, Haika? Can you see the slides?
Yeah, Pak, I can see, Pak.
Right, you can start your presentation starting from now, 10 okay. minutes from now.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I want to present my paper about the optimization of heterogeneous vehicle routing problem using genetic algorithm in courier service. And me as author and Prof. Yuri.
Of coffee perhaps if you want while waiting for the slides coming up. Yeah, okay, please continue, Haika.
Okay, thank you, Pak. The agenda is presentation is first is induction, second literature review, third is methodology, and fourth is result and conclusion. Next, Pak, please.
Yep.
The first is induction. Introduction, sorry. Yep. Introduction, this is just I make this paper because the highest of e-commerce is in trigger to make this paper. The transportation is just not basic people move, but it's goods. And with the transportation, now e-commerce is increasing. So when the increment is increasing in not just in world but in Indonesia too, by increasing the e-commerce, then the business shipping is good increasing too, especially for via courier service and especially in urban area. So I just want to make this paper based on the business courier shipping. Next one. Then first is delivery process consists of multiple route, multiple trips from depot to customer, taking into account type and capacity of the vehicle. Every delivery has a different route between customer, route and sequence of substance or not point must be visited. So from the depot, from the to the node and first node, and the first node to the second node, and they can continue until the delivery is finished and back again to the depot. The determinant of the delivery route is very important to minimize delivery distance, time, number of vehicle, and minimize transport costs. Then the method I to find this solution, I'm using the vehicle routing problem to use a minimal distance or cost. Next part. Then the formulation of the problem and the research proposed is the formulation of the problem, the rise of e-commerce due to technology developed has an impact on the increasing business of the courier shipping today. The increasing number of the customer makes shipping goods more difference both in volume and weight while making different routes using VRP is done using homogeneous vehicle in reality is very difficult to apply. So the problem is the increasing of the delivery of the volume and is very make it very difficult to solve from courier service right now because more difference the shipper the goods and more hard we deliver to deliver because we need the not homogeneous vehicle but heterogeneous vehicle. Then research proposed is the study aims to obtain vehicle VRP or vehicle routing problem, optimize route model for heterogeneous vehicle by grouping customer in the increasing courier service business. Next part. Then second is literature review. Nah, literature review, courier service delivery package in the form of the comment or goods send using a courier, even if this is using the bike, truck, or mobile. The process of courier service is from form of the sending shipment sent by sender collector at one depot and send the customer using vehicle such as car, motorcycle, and trucks. Courier service is required for less for fast and accurate delivery within a specific distance, optimize of vehicle use. And courier mile is goal to speed up delivery, improve the quality of the courier service. Then I use the VRP method to aim minimize the daily cost and the miles of the delivery. Next part. The breakdown of my research is using the research gap method. Research gap, sorry. Then I already collect the study, almost the case using the VRP. Then we use without clustering. So they just using one depot and not clustering the delivery and just the delivery by one node, second node, and third node, and then the depot. They just delivered all the time. Then I found my research gap in the number of nodes and by clustering and heterogeneous vehicle because it is not rare of the research. Next part. Now methodology. Nah, then my first is research steps. First, I conduct literature study by reading the book and I create key main cluster and I want to solve the optimization by using genetic algorithm or GA. Then I refer of research data in courier service company by more than 1,500 data per day or customer per day. Determine the cluster of key main cluster. Determine boundary based on heterogeneous VRP models and calculate optimization with the genetic algorithm. Next. This is my collecting data. Then I collecting data from the company courier service in Jakarta. Then I just take one depot of in urban area, especially like Jakarta Pusat, Jakarta Barat, and Jakarta Selatan. They coverage that area. Then with the three model of the vehicle. First, motorcycle, car, and truck. They will differentiate with the using the type of shipment. So the with like you say, motorcycle just can deliver envelope, cannot deliver box three. Like a car can deliver box one and box two, something like that. Then I get the data with the capacity of vehicle, so the vehicle can reach how many customer a day, and with the maximum capacity, but without the staging. Then the data of customer with the address, postcode, type of shipment, STC, for making the longitude and latitude, then I can make the note of the customer.
You still have 2 minutes.
Yeah, Pak. Okay, Pak. Next, Pak.
Yeah.
This is gaming cluster. I just using the gaming cluster because some of the last paper using the gaming cluster is one of the best of the two clustering the shipment with the big data. Next, Pak. Then this is my VRP model using with the heterogeneous vehicle routing problem. The difference of the VRP model is like time window and else is in subject number two, because this is ensuring the vehicle doesn't not exceed the vehicle capacity. So we just completed capacity and we can choose the which vehicle with delivery, which type of shipment we will deliver. Next part. Then I will optimize by using the genetic algorithm, and basically genetic algorithm by copying process biological evolution by assessing combination and random structure such in population in individual friends chromosome. So based on VRP and with the Keyman cluster, I will optimalization with the using the GA method. Then find the optimal fitness function. Next, Pak.
1 minute.
Okay, Pak. Result and conclusion. Last slide.
Okay,
Pak.
Good.
Not last slide. Two last slide. Yeah. Okay, result. The result, accepting result of this research is to get VRP model with heterogeneous vehicle, determine of number of bands grouping to minimize delay distance, calculate VRP optimization of heterogeneous vehicle by calculate clustering customer. And last but not least, next. Conclusion. This study will provide heterogeneous vehicle model by clustering shipping node using Gmail cluster on large number of customer or data. Get optimal number of cluster by using RSM from the customer postal code focusing. The result of the clustering using the Gmail cluster make parameter for defining solution using the genetic algorithm method. Then combination Gmail cluster and genetic can be accelerated computation and provide efficient in the distance of delivery and number of vehicle, Pak. And that's it for my slide, Pak.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you, Pak. For a good presentation. optimization of the fighter squadron. Squadron, okay, for Indonesian Air Defense. So yes, it's topic, yeah, one of the application of optimization in defense industry. So you have 10 minutes. You can start from now, Pak Gagat.
Thank you, sir. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, best for all of us. My name is Gagat Riando. Today I will present my paper entitled Location Optimization to Factor Squadron for Indonesian Air Defense. Next. Next.
Yeah,
yeah, explore to this paper will be divided into six sections. Next. Indonesian Air Defense Strategy was developed based on the unique and geography of country as the largest archipelago in the world. Indonesian is geographically located between two oceans, Asia and Australia. This caused Indonesia to become one of the world's most important land links. Based on UNCLOS 1982, Indonesia has prepared three sealants of the Indonesian archipelago to be used off route for trade, transportation, and communication of other countries. This makes this maritime region was a strategic value for many countries that Indonesia need to
yeah, it's working. Macam apa?
Malah nggak bisa.
Masanya.
Retro industrial sovereignty can be catered by into two.
Yeah.
First, potential threat. Including potential threats, our threats will occur and the threat can be predicted, even though the escalation of time and potential threats is quite large. One of them is military aggression, as generally triggered by border dispute and exclusive economic zone claims. At the time, vulnerability spread in the Timor Gap, the border of Malaysia, and the most prominent of the South China Sea. The region is claimed to be one side by Chinese on endless line. In this, the development of the region tension also involved short Chinese seas, but used to come up with military power. The United States wants to mince its economy in the Asia-Pacific regions. The FATA region revenue cooperation with several countries, with Singapore, with Australia, Philippines, and Papua New Guinea. And the second threat is actual threats. Category included in this actual threat is terrorism, separatist movement, border conflict, natural disaster, a series of illegal activities that consist transnational crime. Data also show that from January to June 2019, there were 165 violations of territory in border Singapore and Malaysia, and 9971 times in the Papua and surrounding areas. Next. Next, sir. Bisa apa ya?
Going.
Next.
Just a moment.
Recognize the limitation to state, but but kitchen and fetch with the compressor the threat fetch, the Indonesian Air Force has completed a minimum acceleration force of MAF, with a projection of the minimum basicness to of the Iron Indonesian Air Force in 2010 and 2024 to be able to carry out its MAF tax in full. The data used in the paper is number of airbase, itu 10 main airbase and 7 and 2-7 operational base and 2 squadron SU-30 and 4 squadron F-16. Next. Next, sir.
Just a moment. There's been a delay between the operator and the...
Maksud, I'm sorry, yes. Doctor. Determining vessel location of facility is one important factor in the business and military planning process. There are two methods, qualitative methods, example AIP, and quantitative method by optimal mathematics. The two method with advantage and disadvantage of each. But the era of globalization led to the idea to use these two methods together, especially to face the challenge of determining the location in anticipation of unpredictable demand and must be responded quickly in a wet area. Advantage combined the two methods is quantitative and qualitative methods are quickly considered in decision making. Used AAP can reduce subjectivity of assessment of quality factor. Objective of criteria is done with a fairly systematic approach dan enable scenario analysis of our sensitivity assessment. Next. The air dispersal system consists of following elements. In Indonesia, command and control by Kohanutnas and divide for sector mode and detectors element by radar unit, element intercepted and destroyed by fighter aircraft squadron, supporting element by airbase, and defense element by rudal. But in the rudal currently only to be formed. AAP respondent will be given to personnel who are in charge of the air defense system element except the defense element. Instead, it will be given to education element to get an overview study of strategic security issue. Next. In this paper, will feature combine the method of AAP and set method covering to determine to locate the Indonesian Air Force base to be used as a home base as well as base operation Indonesian Air Force Fighter Squadron with the following condition: able to protect all Indonesian airspace, minimize the number of operating base, and maximum factor protection capability. Next. This research method, we have 10 main airbase and 2-7 off spaces, have request RMB and Indonesian Air Force as asset for development. 10 main airbase we select in by AAP to find the best priority back for 6 airbase to be select from 10 main airbase which are candidate at home base of factors aircraft squadron. The standby airbase were chosen because they already have facilities and that meet the requirement to be occupied by factor squadron, but in the front of flat spot and base. Comparison criteria used was taken from two literator and number one from Andi Wijayanto, deterrent strategy and balance strategy, terus number two, by journal by Lee et al. readiness of sporting flight operating facility, readiness-based sport facility, and natural environment. The result of AV method will be optimized using two methods, set covering and pay median, to determine the placement of aircraft types on the mainland and the number of additional operating base to be used to support the national air defense system. Next.
Pak Gagat, you have probably 1 minute left. Is that okay?
Yes.
Yeah. You can go to the result perhaps and conclusion.
Yes.
Okay.
Next.
Result and discussion. Right. This one. Yeah.
Yes. The result, in this paper, AP method used also give weighting to the respondent ASPAR. The weight of respondent ASPAR is based on the following criteria: field of work, education, and rank. This result, education 28.3, field of work 64.3, and rank 7.4. Next. Next.
Yep. Belum.
Maybe.
Tuh, panjangnya. Yeah, sorry for the unsmooth transition slide.
Back to the main airbase. The result, airbase number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6, and number 9. Is 6 the base for from 10 airbase. Next. Next. From set covering problem method, we have home base number 2, 3, 4, and 9, home base for F-60, 5 and 6, home base by to Sukhoi. And main air base number 11, operational base for F-60 and 30 and 39 for operational air base for Sukhoi. Total covering is 14,800 on average 3,700. Next. Maybe next and the conclusion, so.
Yeah. This one.
Yes. Yep. Was used in AP method was used in experiment to determine the priority order of 10 main airfaces to be used at on base of an Air Force Vector Aircraft Squadron. The 10 airfaces were chosen because they already have flight spot facility and base spot facility. 6 airfaces with the highest priority are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 9. When the set covering model, you set to find a right combination of 6 airbase selects from the AIP method with 6 squadron of vector aircraft on it and minimize the number of additional operating airbase to be able to maximize the capability of the vector squadron. The result obtained are 2, 3, 4, and 9 for the 560 and 5 and 6 base for Sukhoi, 11 base for the 560, and 30 and 39 for Sukhoi operational airbase. Next.
delay.
A median method used to maximize the protection capabilities of vector aircraft by minimizing overall distance or average distance per network location. So this model maximizes the result of the set covering problem model. The result of this method there is a change in operation airspace use 11:1 is for 14,000 kilometers to 11 kilometers with an average distance reduced from 3,000 to 2,600. Also, measure the use of the main airbase fan, including the main airbase, so that it can utilize all the facility owned by the airbase. The operating concept. Developing at the operational airbase is to shift the vector plane from the nearest home airbase in the form of flag formation or plane or element formation to planes. Airbase 1 is supported by a vector squadron of airbase 2, 3, or 4. As for airbase 30 and 39, then keep in support from airbase 5 and 6 alternatively. This finish my presentation, sir.
Okay, Riano, for the good presentation. Sorry for the unsmooth technical difficulties, right? Yeah, we are trying to make it as smooth as possible, but the connection is not in our side, actually, unfortunately. So sorry. Okay, maybe one question from the participant regarding presentation from Pak Gagat. Is there any? No question.
Ya, Bapak, ini Pak.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Suara kedengaran, Pak.
Yes, you can still hear. Voice, right?
Your voice not clear, sir, Pak.
Okay. So, Pak Gagat, actually the research presentation, okay?
Yes.
Thank you very much once again, Gagat. Thank you for
the
presentation.
Yes,
good.
Yes.
For the next presentation will be just a minute before we start. Okay. Maharsi, are you there?
Yes. Yes, sir.
You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, let's. I think it's better. I think hopefully we will have a seamless connection. Okay, Mahasi, you will have 10 minutes to present your research, right? I will inform you if the time is up for 2 minutes or 1 minute to go. Okay.
Okay.
Go ahead, Mahasi.
Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Maharshi, and I will be presenting my paper that is Optimization of Tour Package for Sustainable Regional Economic Growth in Kepulauan Seribu, Indonesia. Next, please. Tourism is one of the largest economy industry sectors and has the fastest growth rate in the world. Based on the UNWTO report in 2017, the tourism industry contributed 10% of the world's gross domestic product, or GDP. One out of 10 workers' jobs is also created because of the tourism industry. Indonesia has a very diverse tourism potential. One of them is tourism in Kepulauan Seribu as the new Bali Destination Program. Following the following development policies in special capital region of Jakarta, for DKI Jakarta, the development of Kepulauan Seribu is directed toward tourism activities. Next.
Next.
Tourism of tourists. By 2018 is 777.8 based on the figure. It is known that the number of tourists decreased in 2016 and 2018. While the tourism sector's gross domestic regional product GDRP of Kepulauan Seribu had grown. However, the growth in 2018 decreased by 2.66%. On the other hand, the local government of DKI Jakarta has a target of 7.6% increase of GDRP of Kepulauan Seribu by tourism sector, resulting the target of 900,000 visits in 2020.
Next.
Here the table shows that the condition of coral reefs in Kepulauan Seribu. We can see that in the northeast region, it looks the most different from other regions due to the very small percentage of good coral reefs and a very high number of damaged coral reefs, that is 71.9% damaged and good 28.1%. High tourist growth will affect the marine environment due to excessive cruise visits, air pollution such as vehicle emission, water pollution such as sewage, destruction of wildlife, habitat, deforestation, and damage to coastal areas. Next. So the objective is to design a tour package that can reduce the number of visits and but able to achieve the specified target by the government by 2020, that is 7.6% increase of GDRP. Next. A tour package product is defined by three basic components of tourism: attraction, amenities, and accessibility, or AAA. Existing studies have researched hotels and attraction selection based on preference value to enhance experience of tourists. But in reality, the use of transportation is also one of the factors to enhance experiences. Attractions are tourist attractions that have been prepared to be enjoyed by the tourists, Amenities are the supporting facilities needed to support facilities in the tourism area, such as hotels. And then accessibilities are related to transportation to the destination. Next. This research will design a tour package by preference value using mixed integer linear programming or MILP. This method can achieve the optimal result of a mathematical model represented by linear linear relationship and where some unknown are constrained to be integers. Next, please. This study provides a set of starting points, transportation, hotels, and attractions associated with preference value and availability. The table displays the mathematical notation and descriptions used in this study.
Next.
This study aims to maximize the GDRT by the tourism sectors in Kepulauan Seribu. The equation 2 and 5 to ensure the inclusion of high preference value of variable. The value will be ranked so that the highest value will be selected. Equation 6 to 8 to guarantee the availability on the sites. By the equation 9 is to ensure the achievement of the 2020 GDRT target of Kepulauan Seribu. Next, please. A small case was made for this study. In this case, Kepulauan Seribu has 2 starting points, 2 transportations, 2 hotels, and 2 attractions. Preference value was obtained by distributing surveys to respondents. The survey contained photographs and information on each starting point, transportation, hotel, and attractions in Kepulauan Seribu. Here from the table 1 and table preference value and price, we know that starting point 1 has the preference value 24, starting point 2 has preference value 21, J or transportation 1 is 15, transportation 2 is 22, K for hotel, so hotel 1 is 15, hotel 2 is 23, L for attraction, so attraction 1 is 22, attraction 2, 15. And as for the price, starting point 1 is 25,000 rupiah. Starting point 2 is 20,000 rupiah. Transportation 1 is 200,000 rupiah. Transportation 2 is 50,000 rupiah. Hotel 1 is 300,000 rupiah, hotel 2 is 400,000 rupiah, and for attraction 1 is 20,000, attraction 2 is 10,000. And here for the service availability shows in table A, B, and C. From table A, we can see that the starting point 2 doesn't provide the transportation 1. That is why the value is 0. And as for the table B and C, where the attraction 1 is not available at hotel 2, and so for the transportation 1 doesn't provide a service to the hotel 2. That's why the value is 0. Next. There are several possible solutions from this case, which are shown in table possible solution. The optimum tour package is shown in table tour package solution. The selected starting point is starting point 1. Selected transportation is transportation 1. Selected hotel is hotel 2. And selected selected attraction is attraction 1. So it can be seen that the price offered for a tour package is 645,000 rupiah. Next. To achieve the target given by the local government of DKI Jakarta, an increase of 7.6% of GDRP by using sensitivity analysis, it can be seen that if the number of packages available is 250,000, the increase in GDRP will be 8.04%. Furthermore, if there are 300,000 packages available, the increase in GDRP will exceed the government target. So the total tour package available was 250,000 packages to reduce the environmental damage due to the high visit of tourists in 2018. And the increase in GDRP will be 8.04%. Model in this research can provide solutions for the government in achieving the GDRP increase targets that has been made without having to sacrifice ecosystem in Kepulauan Seribu.
Finish. Okay, no more slides. Thank you very much. Maharsi Anisabila for the presentation. That's very unique. It's about the tourism application, yeah. Tourism in application of optimization in tourism industry. So you are focusing on the Kepulauan Seribu, right?
Yes.
To optimize the PDRB. Is that a GDRP?
GDRP.
Gross domestic
regional
product. Okay, so I will provide the opportunity for participant or for the presenter, the other presenters for asking a question or finding a comment or feedback. Is there any question for Maharsi? Is there any? So we have 11 participants, including me and my co-host, Bro Dava, beside me, that is struggling to connect. To have a good connection. No question? No? Is that clear enough or are you starting to get hungry now? Maybe I will have a one question for you, Maharsi. So how do you for the model, are you?
That's actually a dummy.
Mm-hmm. What kind of data? Dummy data. Yeah. Okay. I probably skip the information, but what kind of data that you collected?
It's a preference value, price.
Preference value. Yeah, that one. So I remember now. So the preference value is coming from the literature from Zeng.
Yes.
Are they observing the same object, which is Kepulauan Seribu, as a preference value, or is that the general preference value?
It's general preference value, but it's for tourism too.
For any kind of tourism, is that?
Yeah, any kind of tourism. But Zeng had research in China.
In China. What kind of tourism object? Is that the natural object tourism or is that the cultural? Because we have quite a lot of type of attraction.
I think Zeng, it's not a natural, but it's about tourism.
It's a kind of general, so we can say that it's a general variable for the any kind of tourism.
Yes.
Okay, that's why you use the same variable for this model as well. Yeah. Okay, interesting. I think let's conclude this the presentation for Maharshi. Thank you very much for the good presentation. Applause for the presentation. Thank you very much. Let's move on to the fifth presenter. We have Firda Azmi Munaziza for the next presenter. Are you ready, Firda?
Ready, sir.
Yeah, you have 10 minutes. Okay, I will remind you the last 2 minutes or 1 minute. Thank you.
Yeah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Firda Azmi Munaziza. I would like to presentation about optimization of the metal at the transportation routes using the multi-objective model. Next, please. I've divided it into a few sections: our introduction, literature review, model and assumption, case study, results, conclusion, and future research. Next, please. First, I will explain about introduction of my paper. National LPG consumption reached above 7.5 million tons with 5.5 million tons imported through imports. Can be seen on the graphic, the import value of LPG is very high compared to export and continue to increase. So the government needs alternative energy to replace LPG. The alternative LPG needed is dimethyl ether or DMA. Dimethyl ether can be produced from various raw material such as natural gas, coal, and biomass. The characteristic of DMA are similar to LPG, making it suitable for substituting LPG. Using DMA in blending LPG DMA is expected to reduce the need for national LPG. Next. The Ministry of Energy and Mineral Resources noted an increase in total coal resources and national reserves. The high amount of coal reserves in Indonesia make PT Pertamina plans to build a DMA plant made from coal in the Bukit Asam Coal Based Special Economic Zone with capacity that requires a strategic of process of DMA land project. Next, please. Okay. Optimization of product transportation is one aspect that influences the reduction project cost. Research purpose of this paper develop a mathematical model to selecting DMA transportation route with several objectives based on economy, environment, capacity, population, and delivery time. Next. Several studies have been carried out for the purpose of determining transportation route. Rao Budiman and Widyadana, 2018, conducted research to optimize several objectives at once. Some of the factors discussed in the study are carbon emission, cost, capacity. In study by Seng et al., 2019, emphasized the importance of reducing pollution and the adverse effect that result from logistical activity. Next, please. Next, please. For more detail, the literature review that has been conducted is presented in the following table. It can be seen that the novelty that I do to add the conservation area variable, which will affect the environment. Next, please. Okay. In this study, determine the minimum transportation cost, minimum action, minimum population, and maximum delivery time. Table 1 display the mathematical notation and description used in this study. Next, please. Basic model assumption used in this study are the environmental aspect study were peatlands and nature conservation. Population data is obtained from the Central Bureau of Statistics Republic of Indonesia of each district. The number of skip tank trucks meet demands, delivery at 22 o'clock every day, and costs used are fuel costs. Okay, this is a mathematical model. In the study, the objective function is minimized Z. There are four goal constraints used in this study. Goal constraint 1 is minimize transportation costs. Goal constraint 2 is minimize emission of transportation. Goal constraint 3, minimize population traverse. And the last goal constraint 4 is maximize time required for delivery. There are two hard constraints used in this study. The conservation area traversed by the route is zero, and the truck capacity is smaller than capacity of the road that can be passed. Next, please. This is the case study. The MA that has been produced will be delivered to LPG depot for blending. The LPG depot is Pulau Layang, South Sumatra, where there are transportation routes traverse shown in figure 2 and transportation routes are simplified in figure 3 is an illustration of the possible path that can be traversed. Next. Okay. This is an assumption of weighting value, Balogun, Matori, and Hamid 2015 formulate the weighting between aspect of environmental criteria, economic criteria, and engineering criteria based on expert opinion respectively. The weighting value of environment is 0.614, economy is 0.11, and engineering is 0.276. This weighting value is then used in completing the goal programming model 5. Okay, this is steps to find optimal routes. The step to find the optimal route for the MA transportation are as follow. One, I find the minimum value for transportation cost, carbon emission, population, and maximum time needed for shipping. The minimum value in a row is 578,343.8, 111.7, 584.95, and the maximum value of time required 319 minutes. And after that, determine the points found along the MA transportation route and the conservation area traversed using the Geographical Information System, or GIS. The software used is MapInfo. Next. After that, I determine the point that can be based on hard constraint, namely conservation area and skip tank capacity. The point that can be based are 1, 2, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, and 10 point. From the point that can be passed, there are two possible routes as follow, option 1 and option 2. Next. Okay. Perform calculation calculation for possible routes according to existing variable, transportation cost, carbon emission, conservation area, population, and time needed. Can be seen in the table, the result of option 1 have a minimum variable value compared to option 2. After that, I determine the weight of each destination. Weight 1, 2, 3, and 4 each goal constraint. Weight is determined based on the level of importance. The result in this study, the most optimum route from calculation result is route 1, point 1, 2, 2, 4, 5, 7, 9, and 10. The deviation value of each one can be seen in the slide. The deviation 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next, please. Okay, the conclusion of the study from the result of the case study, it was found that the proposed model met the requirement of cost, emission, population, and time needed, and overall got the best optimization path. The maximum time will affect the cost. The benefit of this research is to reduce the negative impact of DMA shipment on the surrounding community and reduce transportation costs that will arise. And the result obtained also indicate that using the proposed comprehensive optimization method to optimization DMA transportation routes can help decision makers choose the optimal route. Next. And the future research for the next study is Futurewalk will address larger transportation problem, which include additional obstacle for more realistic problem formulation. In addition, variation in demand need to be considered to estimate optimal inventory, and it also possible to develop tools to overcome scheduling problems which take into account the existing time window. Okay. Okay, that's all from me.
Thank you for the presentation. It's about the DME, dimethyl ether.
Yeah.
Distribution, dimethyl ether transportation routes using multi-objectives model. So you are collecting data from South Sumatra? Bukit Asam?
No, I collect data in Pertamina.
Pertamina, okay.
Yeah.
So you don't have to go to there.
No.
Yeah. All right. Is there any question, feedback, comment from the floor, from the participant, or from the other presenters? Please.
Are you calculating the? Sorry, Pak. Haikal, Pak.
Go ahead, Haikal.
Are you calculating the emission? You're done.
Yeah.
How you calculate the emission?
Good question.
Okay. I calculating the emission from full consumption. Sorry.
It's okay.
Okay, the emission carbon from skid tank calculation it from full consumption times fuel emission factor.
Okay.
Emission factor in percent.
Yeah. Any feedback, Haika?
No, Pak.
Clear enough.
Clear enough.
So there's an emission factor times the fuel consumption so that you can get the figure of emission, right? So you a little bit from me. So you are using multi-objective for your model, right? Is that the what kind of the objective? Yes. Economic objective.
Sorry.
What kind of objective do you have?
For.
Sorry.
For objective.
Yeah. You said that it was multi objective, so it's more than one objective, right?
Yes.
What are they?
Economy.
Economy.
Environment, population.
And population.
Population and time. Yeah.
So three objectives.
And time.
And time. Okay, so you are optimizing both three objectives in the simultaneously, right? You are using a kind of a weighting, right?
Yeah.
From the literature.
Mm. Yeah.
Okay, interesting. So I think that's conclude your session, Firda. Thank you very much once again for your presentation.
Thank you for attention.
Thank you. And let's move to the last but not least presenter. We have Lutfi Wicaksono, which the title of paper is Optimization of Energy, Economy, Environmental, and Waste Management Strategies and Policies in Indonesia. So, Lutfi, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Where are you? I cannot see you. Your video. Okay, now I can see you. I should drag the video. Right, okay. You have, I can hear your voice. Okay. Quite good. You have 10 minutes starting from now.
Today I want to present our work that the title is Optimization of Energy, Economy, Environmental, and Waste Management Strategies and Policies in Indonesia. The work is led by myself and my supervisor, Mr. Farizal Peiti, and Professor Dr. Jokasana Gabriel. Next, please.
Next.
Indonesia is the world's most populous country in the world. As you can see on the graph, about 2.54% of world population are Indonesian citizens. Next, please. With more than 240 million people in 2012 and getting higher to more than 260 million people in 2018, 2018. Next, please. But not only population is getting higher, but also GDP, electricity consumption, so the emission numbers also getting higher. GDP per capita in Indonesia continues to increase from 3,500 in 2014 and getting almost $4,000 in 2018. And electricity consumption in 2012 was productive in about 200 kilowatt hour, which is doubled from 2002, just only produced about 110 kilowatt hour. Carbon emission in Indonesia has grown exponentially from early 70s to 2007, CO2 volume increased by 191%. Meanwhile, rapid development in population and acceleration of economic activity increases higher forms of organic waste, plastic packaging, industrial products. The government of Indonesia with Presidential Regulation Number 22 and 97 for 2017 and National Medium-Term Development Plan or RPGMN have a target in economy, energy, environment, and waste sector. The target growth of economic growth by an average of 6% annually based on RPGMN. The target of electricity consumption is to 2,500 kWh per capita based on presidential regulation and the reduction target of CO2 emission from 14 million tons CO2 equivalent has just only become almost 900 million tons CO2 equivalent. In 2025, Indonesia is also projected to produce 70.8 million tons of waste. Next, please. Research on economic issues, energy emission, and waste has been a hot topic for the past 2 years, like San Cristobal and 2012, like model combined simulation between economy, energy, environmental effect, providing valuable information for policymakers. They are going to be looking at a potential set of among the objectives. The objectives are GDP growth, electricity consumption, and resource allocation. Some of the economic extended indicates among economic growth, energy consumption, financial development, set of emissions, CO2 emissions, peruang kereta in 2015, optimus pemotif objektif model for the sustainability of electricity in Indonesia with economic analysis, so the research and the adequacy of energy sources. And the last one is Paris et al. In 2018, discovered the optimal proportion of municipal solid waste through the TR program, reducing waste cycle and waste energy program. Next, please. But several factors regarding energy economy, so the emission and waste are conflicting, like economic objectives are typically opposed to environmental objectives, since the economic activity requires the exploitation of natural resources and generate numerous of waste that could impact the environment. To developing country like Indonesia, even you have target to reduce every process emission, it's contradict with the agenda for economic growth and labor growth. Next, please. Okay. So the objective of this research is to analyze the optimal resource application simultaneously to satisfy energy, economic, environmental, waste and waste management sector from the strategies and policy was made before. Yes. The data, the GDP data is taken from Central Statistics Agency of Republic US in Indonesia. The data is GDP by sector in 2018 from the first quarter to fourth quarter. CO2 emission is taken from International Energy Agency. City consumption is taken from Ministry of Energy and Mineral Resources of Indonesia, and waste sector based on residential irrigation number 97 by 2017. Next, please. This is the model that we developed. We are using a global programming model. Next. So, this is the scenario. The target in the three scenarios are the targets for 2025 taken from various sources. There are three scenarios in which we study. The first one is business as usual scenario. The second one based on the international energy plan, or we call GRUEN, which there is a CO2 emission reduction target. And the third one is based on general plan for electricity supply, or EPL. In the scenario, there is a target of selling electricity consumption, which is the target is only about 361 gigawatt hour. Okay, this is because we use a global programming model in the case of maximization in the global consent. In the objective function of global programming, we minimize the negative deviation in the case of minimization. In the objective of global programming, we minimize the positive deviation. In the first scenario, the GDP target produces a negative deviation of about $375 billion. And CO2 emission producing negative deviation about 250 million tons CO2 equivalent, electricity consumption about 560 gigawatt hour negative deviation, waste has produced a positive deviation about 6.57 million tons, waste energy produced about 42,000 gigawatt hour of negative deviation. With resource allocation to the fourth sector, the fourth sector is household sector of the allocation of household sector of about 142 million. People, the allocation of industrial sector about 95 million people, commercial sector about 23 million people, and the transportation sector about 19 million people. Next. Okay, in the second scenario, the results are slightly different from the first scenario, a scenario with a decrease in the target of CO2 emission. The positive of CO2 emission are likely close to zero, so I think we can say it's zero, so it can go to the target. But there were trade-offs with other targets, deviation in other objectives are increased, but the positive deviation of waste are decreased to 5.28 million tons of waste, with an allocation of household sector about allocation of household and industrial sector is same like the first scenario. The commercial sector about 28 million people, the allocation of transportation about 13 million people. Next. Okay, the third scenario, with a reduction of electricity consumption target, the negative deviation generated at the electricity consumption decreased to 105,000 gigawatt hour, but there was a top on the GDP target with the increase more than $400 billion of negative deviation. The emission and waste target can be controlled to the target. The waste to energy target still produce negative deviation about 43,000 gigawatt hour. With an allocation of household sector is same like the first two scenario. The allocation of industry sector about 106 million people, allocation of commercial about 27 million people, then the last one, transportation sector about 5 million people. Next. Okay, from the first objective, are the government target on in the economic objective if not achieved at all in all scenario? So I think the economic growth of 6% acts likely to hike under the current condition. And next one, compared to the second and the third scenario, there are trade-off between electricity consumption and CO2 emission. On the third scenario, even electricity consumption produces negative deviation less than the second scenario. But in the first scenario, produce more than the produce CO2 emission more than the second scenario. So I think the implementation of renewable energy sources is one of important measures, so that project electricity consumption can be reached without increasing a large of CO2 emission. And last one is in the first and second scenario, the total generated waste exceeds the projection proposed by the government. So I think the utilization of waste energy can be the one of the solutions, so it can reduce waste generation and increase electricity production. Yeah. This is the reference that I use for this presentation. That's all. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Lutfi Wicaksono, for the good presentation. It's an interesting topic as well. So it's optimization of energy, economy, environmental, waste management strategy. So I saw that you were using quite a lot of objectives, right?
Yeah, so five
from the SDG objective. Yeah.
Yeah.
I see also another four for the industry. Is that that's the object?
What? Sorry.
I saw as well there are four other objectives like industry and household.
Oh. Yeah.
That's also the objective, right?
Yeah.
They try to maximize.
Minimize. Some goal constraint are to maximize, and the other one is to minimize. So, but in the goal programming model, we have to minimize all the deviation.
Yeah, I can see that. Okay, first of all, I want to provide the opportunity for the participants or the other presenters to have a question or feedback comment. This is the last one, but not least. So you can use one person can ask one question, so you can have seven questions for the last one.
Oh no.
Let's ask something. No? Well, we are in the lunch time now. But okay, no question at all. One question, two questions, no? Mirza perhaps? Terus, Aika, for hat trick? No.
Enough, Pak. No, Pak.
It should be me to ask you a question then. Is that okay? Okay, just to remind you that we will have a, before we leave this session, let's have a photo session together, right, after this. Okay, about the optimization of energy, economy, environmental, waste management. So I saw there are three different scenarios you are using. The first one is business as usual, right?
Yes.
What is the name of the second scenario?
To reduction of CO2 emission scenario.
The second one, the second scenario two?
CO2 emission reduction.
Scenario. The scenario four or three?
To reduce the electricity consumption target scenario.
Reduce the electricity consumption. So scenario two is about reduce emission. Scenario three is about the reduce consumption. Right?
Yeah.
You are simulating based on those three scenarios. The target is too high.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's not. In that sense, the target that is defined by the government is too high. So what's your recommendation then? Is that to lower the target, not 6%, but lower than that, or what?
What
recommendation?
For the GDP target, sir?
Mm-hmm. You said that in conclusion that all of those scenarios,
yeah,
cannot
it's lower than the targets about the target.
Then what does it mean?
It means that the target about 6% it can reach with the current condition. So I think we have to make a realized target. Then so it means that we have to project it below the 6% annually.
So you will recommend to the our government to lower a bit?
If there is a chance, so I think I can.
Yeah, based on your model, you can try to find the good the right person to deliver your aspiration based on your research, because this is the result of the research.
Right.
Yeah, no more question from the participant, no comment. If not, then let's turn on the video camera, perhaps all of us, all the participants can join. Please welcome if you like. I don't force you to open, but if you like, you can enjoy this session. We can have a photo session together. According, Rusman and Mirza Arshad, do you want to join us? No, or you can stay incognito. Okay, if you don't want to, we can see we have 10 participants. We'll have a photo session together. Hang on a minute. We will have a formal session now, formal style. Should I? Yeah, one. Right. Once again. This is for the proof of participation. Actually, if actually for the publication objective, yeah. Because sometimes the SEM, the publisher, will ask the proof of participation or proof of presentation. Yeah, you ready? One, two, three. Freestyle. What about the freestyle? Let's have a freestyle. One more, two more. It's too close for me. How to like this one or this one? Not like this one. Okay, the Korean style. One, two, three. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much for your presentation. Applause for everybody. Let's close this session, and I hope you enjoy the presentation. You have the fruitful discussion, and we are not finishing yet. We are still the conference will still running, till end of the day, till the afternoon. So you can easily, you can freely join any session you want. Yeah, you can just click the link and you can join any session. If you want to watch your friend do the presentation or any scholar from other institution as well, you can watch the presentation and you can ask anything. Yeah, and regarding to the certificate, because you will receive the certificate. It will be distributed probably tomorrow, because we will collecting all the participation number and then distributing all the certificates to all of you, probably using, you will get the information from the WhatsApp group about the certificate. Okay. Actually, after this, we normally will have the lunch together, but now we are in the virtual environment, so we will have the lunch virtually. So you can go, you can order the food online, or you can go to your kitchen, you can anything, you can do it. After this, it's a free time, and you can continue to join the conference if you like. We still have one more keynote speaker, don't forget, from TU Berlin, Professor Paul. So it will be interesting to see the presentation. Please keep in touch, and please join the session. Okay, thank you very much for your participation and your cooperation. Thank you. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and good. Afternoon. Bye.
Thank you.
I'm signing off. Thank you.
Thank you,
Pak. Thank you all. Sami.
Pak Zul. Sudah lapor ya?
Yeah. Sorry?
Pak Zul, after the, sorry, not... speaker not number two. What will we do? Because the in the schedule just a presentation,
yeah. Yeah, your obligation is just to present your paper. But you you all have presented your paper, so you have done the job. Now it's a free time. You can freely join any kind of session if you want. So,
thank you.
Yours, at your time.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, Pak. Thank you, Pak.
Thank you, Pak. Thank you, bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam.